Okay, I'm here because there's a man named Jesus Christ who transformed my life and who should be transforming all of yours, and who told the world he was sent by God, that he was God, and that everything in the Bible is legit, and that we need to hurry up and repent because we're crazy sinners, and that turn our eyes upon the one who created us. Because guess what? This life does end, and guess what? There's a heaven and a hell. We gotta jump on that. Figure that thing out. So anyway, this morning, this is what the Lord gifted to Linwood, most likely to everyone else too. This is what I saw in Linwood. You got it. You just got it. Come on. Come on now. Come on now. For reals. For real. When people say, there's no God, like there's no proof that there's God, and this Bible has been interpreted like how many times? We don't even know. And how can that even be legit? And like, what about all the other gods? And okay, this is a creator. This is screaming a creator. Do you know, can I just side note, this is not, was not planned on mentioning, but my gracious. Here, I have a note on my phone called Silly Atheists. No, it's called Foolish Evolutionists. Dawkins says, biology is the study of complicated things that give the appearance of having been designed for a purpose. Could you think that is because they were designed for a purpose, and Dawkins, you just hate God because you have some beef with him and you don't understand his mysterious ways? Yeah. Francis Crick, another evolutionist, says, biologists must constantly keep in mind that what they see has not been designed, but rather evolved. They have to like constantly renew their mind, like this isn't God, just because it would go against what they, it would make them, hi James, I'm making a video. Okay. So these evolutionists who are studying biology and studying this world, two men are saying they constantly have to tell themselves, this is not made by God. Oh, there's no, it's the creator. Just because they basically hate him. They think they say he doesn't exist just because, you know, I don't think he's doing this whole God thing correctly. So foolish. Anyhow, and then after seeing this morning's incredible, incredible artistry of a creator, this is not the impossible lie that everything came from nothing. It just can't. Life cannot come from nothing. There has to be a creator. And there has to be a creator. It just really, in Romans 1, there are some really, really, really great verses in here. The Bible is God's word to us. Everything in the Bible is true. That's why God gave it to us, to enlighten us, to open our eyes to our sin and our need for him. And okay. Romans 1, verse 19 says, for what can be known about God is plain to them, them being those that deny God's existence, because God has shown it to him. Look outside when there's a sunrise or a sunset. See a baby, brand new. Those things are God's very awesome, awesome, obvious existence. For his invisible attributes, namely his eternal power and divine nature, have been clearly perceived ever since the creation of the world in the things that have been made. So they, again, the people that don't believe in God and think, well, there's no proof. They are without excuse. For although they knew God, you guys all know who the heck this God is. You know who God is. You deny his existence because you don't want to follow his commandments because you think they'd make your life less awesome. That's a lie from Satan, yo. And for although they knew God, they did not honor him as God or give thanks to him, but they became futile in their thinking and their foolish hearts were darkened. So when you guys say things like, well, you shouldn't be judging because Jesus was never judging. And why are you judging me? And that's so hateful. Because Christians, well, not all Christians, because a lot of Christians, they claim to be a Christ follower, but they don't read the Bible ever. They are awful human beings. So just because someone says they're Christian, don't say, oh my gosh, you do all these things, I do not want to follow Christ, if that's what it does. Because a lot of Christians, well, all Christians are imperfect. And a lot of people might say, oh yeah, when I was 4, my pastor told me to pray this prayer and that made me Christian, so I'm Christian. But I don't actually like know who the heck God is, so, or Christ, or what he taught. So that's not a Christian. So when Gandhi said, I love your Jesus, but I hate you Christians, guess what? A lot of them weren't actually followers of Christ, they just called themselves Christians. But yeah. When people are angry because a Christian judges them, guess what? It's not us judging. It's Jesus. We're just saying God's words. He's the one that calls your heart foolish. Okay? Anyhow. Y'all that believe that God does not exist, you all that believe that Christ is not God, guess what? Ask yourself why. Okay? And I would love if you sent me a message as to why, and we can talk about that. Because I know a few atheists that have told me the reason they don't exist is because of lack of proof. But here's the thing. In the Bible, Jesus walked and talked and did miraculous things, and a handful of people or more said, you are God, you are the Messiah we've been waiting for, you are Him, and they fell to their knees and they worshipped Him, okay? And then there were people right next to them, shoulder to shoulder, that said, you are not God, you need to be killed, you need to be murdered, our God, yes, is sending a Messiah, but it's not you, Jesus, because you are poor, you are not beautiful, and it's... In the end, guys, it's a heart issue, because even if you say right now, I just need proof, if God himself stood before you, a lot of you would still not worship him as your Lord and your Savior, because you don't want to follow this incredible book that is the Bible. You don't want to follow. Here's the thing, because you don't want to follow this, because there's stuff in here that makes you think, oh. What is that? You don't care to study it. You look in here and say, wait. So I had a teacher that told me something opposite of this. We are constantly hearing this other message from the world that we need to be tolerant, but tolerant means hating Christians, because that's just part of it. And we need to just look like everyone's religion just needs to be, let them embrace it, because you know, that's just showing love. But it's not, because in the end, if there's a heaven and a hell, and what Jesus said is true, there's only one way to get to heaven, and that is through Him. He says that. So if you're being loving to your Buddhist friend because you're not telling them that their religion is wrong, guess what? You're actually being totally hateful, because if they die tomorrow, they're going to hell. How is that loving? Loving is to say, Buddhist friend, come here. Hey, what do you believe? How did you get to that conclusion? Let's look at the, I don't know if they have a prophet. Let's look deeper. Hey, Muslim friend, what do you believe and why? Oh, Muhammad, let's study Muhammad. Was he legit? Because I believe that Jesus was legit and their messages were completely the opposite. So let's study our prophets. Let's study, let's study our prophets and see whose life, see who historically can be believed, you know? Like, let's say, hey, Mormon friend, let's just study this Joseph Smith guy. Is he for real? Is this everything he said and gave you the Book of Mormon? Is that truth? Like, let's study this, but we're so lazy. We'd rather just look on Instagram and look at like cute quotes and fun quotes and encouragement from all these other people. But guys, Guys, we're all gonna die someday. Does anyone need proof of that? Does anybody not believe that? No, we all know we're gonna die. Okay? And Jesus came and said, I am the only way to the Father. Repent, because you're foolish and you're wicked and you're rebellious. Repent. Confess that that's not bringing you life, and follow the one who formed you in your mother's womb. God formed us in our mother's wombs, y'all. Like, he knows us pretty dang well. And this word is incredible, and all it talks about from the beginning in Genesis to the very end in Revelation, which I haven't studied yet, and it seems pretty crazy but amazing. All he's talking about, all you read, if you read this, okay, have any of you actually read this, like, from the beginning to the end? Because I haven't. I'm working on it. It takes time. It's a pretty long book. Someone said, I just heard it the other day, it is, if someone does not become a Christian after reading the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, they will become a Christian the second time that they read it. Like, if someone just said, you know, I'm going to read this book, what the heck is it about? I'm just going to see what this is about. Isn't that incredible? That's incredible. So anyhow, a lot of us have not read this. And if you did, I started reading from the very beginning. And the entire thing is one mentioning God's great love and how he gives and gives and gives. Two, man's deep sin and how we disobey and disobey and disobey. Three, God's patience, how he gives us another chance, another chance, another chance. Four, Christ, Christ, Christ. Jesus is mentioned so many times and prophesized about in the Old Testament. It just talks about there's a Savior coming, a light is coming, you guys are in darkness, like, someone's coming, I'm gonna rescue you because you're totally wicked and you need someone to rescue you. Guys, read this Bible. Let's do a Bible study at lunch on Mondays. That's the only day I'm at work. Or Saturday afterwards. Let's study this book, okay? Let's study this. And if you're Muslim or Jehovah's Witness or Mormon or Buddhist or Hindu or so many religions, let's study the founder of your faith. Let's study Muhammad and Joseph Smith. Let's study your atheism and Darwin and, like, whatever. Let's study this, because guess what? There's so many errors, flaws, lies, and everything else. Legit. I know this isn't, like, something that anyone cares to listen to. You're like, wow, that's really hateful of you to say everyone's wrong except for you. No, it's not. Jesus said it. It was Jesus is God. He has every right to tell you you are wrong. Okay? Just saying what he said. Anyhow, this morning, that sun. Remember that sunrise? God exists. God exists. If you actually study the life of Christ, of this Jesus that lived, that came from Nazareth, if you study him using the Bible and other historical texts, he was actually a legit historical figure. Jesus existed, and everything he said is true. These in Matthew, the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, well, Matthew, Mark, and John, they are eyewitnesses. They saw and they wrote it down, guys. There are more original manuscripts of the Bible than any other historical text. So all those historical figures that you studied and were taught about in high school and other in elementary school, middle school, there is less evidence that any of those people existed, because those books were written far more years after those people actually existed. And in the Bible, if you guys study, look up Josh McDowell. He studied the original manuscripts, the time period from when Jesus walked the earth to when these people wrote about him. And it's these small little windows, small windows, I think 100 years, 50 years. Don't quote me on that. Study it. Don't be lazy. Don't try and get everything from this video. I am nothing. I am like two little, tiny little whiffs of a giant feast. Like a never-ending feast. Like one that lasts for eternity. Guys, this is real. And I know you don't want to follow him, because that'd mean you have to stop sleeping with your boyfriend and looking at porn, and you'd have to be honest, and you'd have to like change your music listening styles, and like you'd have to stop cussing, and you'd have to actually glorify him. And that's not fun, and that doesn't seem pleasant to you, but there is abundant life in it, I swear to you. Y'all, I had to stop lots of things, but it wasn't that like I had to. It's the fact that when you get on your knees and you say, oh my gracious, gracious God, you exist, and I am a wretch, and I don't deserve any of your love, and I have sinned and sinned and sinned and sinned and sinned against you very intentionally, and my God, Jesus, is you are my savior, you came and died for me, and oh my gosh, I repent, I am nasty, I want to follow you the rest of my life. When you do that and you start eating this every day, eating is like when you eat a meal, right? You eat bread every day, right? This is called our daily bread. You open this every day and you have some, because otherwise your spirit will be starving. You're gonna start following what you hear on the Facebooks is, and that's not awesome, and the Instagrams is. When you are in this, listening to God, reading his word, studying it, meditating on it, your life will change. You will not care to be doing your awful things. You will not want to, because he gives us this gift called his Holy Spirit. It goes into us. You don't see it. He gives you his spirit. That's a promise in his word. He gives you his spirit, and it will shake you. Not literally. Y'all, I just need to like work on my Christianese, they call it. It will cause you to feel gross when you do sinful things. It will cause you to feel gross when you yell at your child like the monster you are. I do that all the time. I did that all the time. I do it a lot less now, because when I'm about to do it, I realize this isn't going to help him at all. And so I stop and I say, Lord, how the heck can I glorify you right now? And I just start singing, because I can't do a whole lot to stop from you. I don't have a whole lot of self-control. I can't be like, Lord, can you help me right now to not yell like it? No! I'm like, be thou my vision, because I want to kill someone. No, you know, like, I'm not. Okay. Anyhow, guys, God exists. Jesus exists. Walked this world, this earth. Told us the truth. We got to study him. And let's do it quickly, because we could die tomorrow. Because, like, there's the crazies out there. There's crazies out there. Obviously, we see it all the time. In our life, we have no idea when we're gonna go. So, this message is urgent. Repentance is urgent. Falling to our knees before our Creator is urgent. Let's follow him. Let's study this. I wanna study it with you, because I'm learning all these cool things. Let's study this.